Skyboat Media presents The Flying Cutterbucks by Kathleen M. Rodgers. This book is read by F. Michelle Williams. Dedication. To the fearless women in my life, my sisters, Laura, Doran, Gulliford, for letting me tag along to the library early on where you devoured chapter books, and Jo Linda, Doran, Rivetta, whose passion for dance inspires all of us. We come from a hardy line of women who persisted and took risks. In loving memory of author Drima Hall Berkheimer, when I butchered words, you gently corrected me and loved me anyway. As Terry and Tom said, you're a little girl again, running down a red dog road with Sissy into the sunshine. And to Arlene Guillen, Joe's best friend since second grade. Days before Drima slipped away, the muse whispered, when one door closes, another opens. And now, here we are, helping each other write our stories. Election Day, 2020. Jewel Cutterbuck tried to control her trembling hand as she picked up the remote control and pointed it at the television. Mr. Grumples, her sister's cat, heard and jumped up on Jewel's lap. Instead of shooing him away, she welcomed his warmth on this chilly November night. As she waited for election results to come in from around the country, her thoughts hopscotched from who was going to be the next president of the United States to the dark and disturbing secret her eldest daughter had shared with her the previous day. A noise came from the kitchen. Glancing sideways, Jewel saw it was only the big yellow dog pushing her food dish around. Nothing to fear there. Settling back into the sofa, Jewel turned her attention to the news and waited. Chapter 1. Trudy Returns. Pardon, New Mexico, October 2016.
Sister, did you hear what the orange cheese puff said? It's all over the news.
Aunt Star's crotchety voice crackled from the tiny speaker of the cell phone into the stale air of Jewel Cutterbuck's cluttered living room.
He was caught on tape bragging about grabbing women's lady parts.
Trudy swiveled in the worn recliner and gazed across at her mother, Jewel, an aging beauty queen who'd let the contents of her household pile up around her like sand dunes. For Trudy, the sound of Aunt Star's voice functioned as both a welcome and a warning. Jewel frowned at the cell phone in her hand like a stink bomb had gone off.
Good God, Star, what will the man say next?
Jewel sat on one end of the sagging gold velvet sofa, flanked on both sides by Spanish-style end tables from the 70s.
He used the P word, sister.
All the networks are talking about it. Jewel's jaw dropped as she scooted forward and placed the phone on a stack of books on the ornately carved coffee table.
You mean like meow?
She covered her mouth with a delicate hand freckled in liver spots to stifle a giggle. Trudy bolted out of the recliner, letting the back of the rocker thump against the textured wall. The song made famous by Tom Jones crooned in her head. Bending over the coffee table, she cupped her hands on her knees and blurted into the cell.
What's new, pussycat?
Aunt Star roared with laughter on the other end of the line.
Lovey, is that you? When did you roll into town?
Hey, Aunt Star, about 5 minutes ago. Trudy glanced up at her mother and winked.
Mama Jewel and I were just discussing what to have for supper. You girls should splurge and go to Fur's cafeteria. They serve everything but alcohol.
Jewel leaned forward on the sofa, jutting her chin toward the phone.
Star, Fur's closed 2 months ago. I'm going to miss their baked fish and banana pudding.
Star sighed on her end.
Sister, I sure hate to hear that. Next thing you know, Pardon's going to dry up and blow away, especially since the base closed.
Was it Trudy's imagination, or did her mother's whole body change when Aunt Star mentioned the base? The place where Trudy was born. The last place they'd waved goodbye to her.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.